Right now, we have a program of research. It's funded 5 years through the Canadian Institute of Health Research, and we have four First Nation communities as partners in our research. And I say partners specifically because they are our partners. They're not our subjects of the research. They participate fully in every aspect of what we do as a group together. The communities that are involved in our research, they define the problem. They also define their solutions, and we as researchers work with them, document that experience and assist them along that way any way that we can. But what's happening in the project that we work on in First Nation communities is that each First Nation has taken the leadership and ownership of developing their own palliative care program and team in their community. And what that looks like is that each community has developed an advisory committee. And these advisory committees are different. They've been established completely different, and there's different members on it. But these are the individuals who have taken ownership and control of the project at the local level. They're the ones that tell us who we speak to, what we say, what we don't say. They ensure that everything we do is following their local culture, practices, and traditions. And we work with them. And the goal of what we're doing with these communities is the overall goal is to develop a palliative care program and team in each of these four communities. And what we're going to do then is document that experience, document what is happening, and develop a toolkit. And that toolkit is going to be shared with all First Nation communities across Canada so that should they want to develop a palliative care program in their own communities, it'll be kind of like a how-to guide. I say palliative care program very loosely, though, because in some communities, and in particular communities that we work with, they don't call it palliative care. Depending on their local cultural protocols and practices, they may not even say end-of-life care. So for a lot of the communities, it's a community care project on how to care for their own people. So we're working with each community, and we've done a needs assessment in each of these communities to really find out from the community's perspective, what is the needs? What are those barriers? What is it that the community wants? The communities are experts of their own experience. They know what they want. They know what they need. They don't need somebody from the outside coming in and saying, here's this nice little program wrapped up in a box. Here, you can do this. Because that doesn't work. It's been proven that it doesn't work. So the communities are kind of developing their own, taking a look at internally at what their own needs are, developing strategies and goals to find ways to meet those needs. And then the external healthcare providers are there to support them in that process, support them through, you know, if they come back and they say, well, we need some education for our healthcare providers on palliative care. It's that's kind of where the external resources can be used in the community to help them develop a program. So educating their families, educating the community members, educating their healthcare providers. One of the benefits of working with the First Nation communities and connecting them with those external health resources is really to address a lot of those barriers to in terms of lack of communication. So what we're finding in the research that we're doing is the external healthcare providers, they don't have a lot of education in terms of cultural safety or cross-cultural communication. So they're learning from the First Nation healthcare providers, from the First Nation community members, and vice versa. And that's kind of one of the benefits of doing what we're doing is because it's a learning experience for everybody. And each community is going to develop their own program and their own team, and each community's team and program is going to be a little bit different depending on what kind of local resources they have. We're not waiting for the funding to come. I was in a presentation this morning and, you know, they were saying if we waited for everything to be in place, nothing would ever happen. So the communities are working with the capacities that they currently have. So their healthcare providers, their leadership, the programs that they currently have, and they're building upon that. And we as a research team are helping them, we're facilitating that process, and we're building that capacity from within the communities. It's going to be, we have it for 5 years, our program of research is 5 years, and one thing about community capacity development is that it doesn't ever end. There's no infinite line that says, okay, the project is done, now, you know, everything is done. This is going to continue on, And that's that sustainability piece that we have to build in with the communities.